High-cost short-term credit borrowers are often associated with low-income backgrounds. However, as the gig economy grows and personal savings are lower than ever, more middle-income professionals rely on these loans. Sunny, part of Elevate Credit International, conducts rigorous affordability assessments to ensure responsible and ethical lending. Julie McDonald reports.
Britain in the grip of economic gloom and an unsettled future with Brexit on the horizon.
Increasingly, thanks to wage stagnation, economic uncertainty and an increase in the gig economy, more and more people both on low and surprisingly on middle incomes are accessing short-term credit. But how can they get good rates and fair treatment?
Formerly poorly regulated, the sector was awash with lending horror stories and few alternatives for those underserved by the mainstream lenders. Working mum Leanne Norton is one of a number of people turning to short-term credit so she could provide for the arrival of her twins.
At first it was all exciting and then it's like a feeling at the pit of the stomach, a bit like, oh my God, how are we going to cope? How are we going to do this? The girls are turned one and we only had one cot. And they'd outgrew it, they were sleeping in it together, so we needed to get another cot.
Leanne took a short-term, affordable loan, which she's since paid off. The twins got their cot, and she says being able to get that short-term loan is a real lifeline for many struggling families.
I researched a lot of them, because I didn't want to just have the whole 6 months of worry. Yeah, no, it had to be affordable. Makes you feel like you're in control. Like, we could just go and get the stuff that we needed, and it felt really accessible.
Even across those on middle incomes, demand for short-term credit is growing. We approached Leanne's loan company, Elevate Credit, an award-winning short-term loan provider, to find out how the market is changing.
Our kind of customers are people that have jobs, they have bank accounts, they have mobile phones, And if you look at their household income, it's not very far off of the UK national average. So it's really this dynamic of people having so much less savings.
For Elevate's managing director, Scott Griever, it's about having a constant conversation with their customers who recently voted them champions of treating customers fairly.
One of the most important things we do is we have an internal profit cap of 20% on our gross profits. When we get close to that number, first and foremost, we want to actually start lowering our rates for our customers. And second, it also then says, then that means we need to be reinvesting back in our business, in our people, in our capabilities, so that we can serve more consumers.
The Financial Conduct Authority clamped down on payday lenders in 2014, and there's more regulation in the pipeline.
So that's brought generally a lot more scrutiny to the sector. It's ended things, it's brought in things like interest rate caps and limited rollovers, which was a massive source of complaints. And actually what it's done is it's made some of the firms that really weren't in it for the right reasons head off into the sunset. And what we're left with is a more professional group of firms that are trying to kind of raise standards in the industry and see that as vital to their survival too.
But even pre-regulation, the focus here has always been on lending fairly.
It's important to offer the right loan to the right person. So if an individual has lent an amount of money that they can't afford, that individual loses. That's a bad situation for them. It's also a bad situation for the person that lends the money.
So for Leanne and millions of other customers like her, underserved by the big banks and credit card companies, the availability of short-term loans alongside fair customer treatment is vital. Without it, many feel they have nowhere to turn.
When it comes to your children, you do anything for them. And then when you feel like there's something you can't do for them, it's really gets you. You know, so it really, really did help.